Hi everyone, and welcome to our tutorial on dual skins. For a long time already, you could create skins in 3DVista that were responsive, meaning that while you initially designed and put together a skin meant for a desktop screen, you could make these elements so that they automatically adapt to a smaller mobile screen, say by defining their size and percentages. That meant that skins which were not too complex could easily adapt to other screen sizes by slightly moving the elements and making them a little bit bigger so you'd be able to click them with your finger on a phone. If skins got a little bit more complicated, however, you could easily run into problems where elements shifted over each other, buttons would get hard to click, and info windows such as this one, which were designed for a big landscape screen, simply aren't compatible with a small vertical screen. So while responsiveness makes things work, it does not necessarily translate your skin into the ideal mobile user experience. In many occasions, an interface designed for desktop screens does not make any sense to just adapt for a vertical mobile visualization. Instead, mobile may require an architecture and design completely different and thought from scratch. That's where the new dual skin editor comes into play. Because what we need for our tours to go from good to excellent is more than just the media quality. It's the design and architecture of the interface that surrounds them. Welcome to Dual Skins. Especially for mobile devices, you need a design that does more than just adapt. It needs to optimize. It needs to be perfect for the layout and dynamic of a mobile phone where instead of a mouse, you use your finger. So ideally, a mobile user experience needs to start from scratch. Are there skin elements which don't need to be shown on mobile at all? Are there elements which completely need to be relocated? Are there elements which should be combined under a new unfold button? Anything that may make sense to keep a smaller vertical screen free from clutter and buttons easy to push even with one hand. Now, instead of having to create a completely new skin just for mobile, let alone a completely new virtual tour for mobile, you can use what's our latest addition to the skin editor, dual skins. Dual skins means that one and the same virtual tour will have two skins, one for desktop and one for mobile or tablet devices, which you can optimize with just a couple of touches. The tour itself will detect which device a user is watching the tour on and respectively show one or the other perfectly optimized skin for that. First, let me show you what's changed in the actual viewer, so this area right here, which is where we place and thus compose our skin. This viewer now allows you to preview a skin design much faster and more real to see what your skin would look like on different devices without having to export the tour and actually open it on a mobile device. Therefore, up here we can select the most common mobile types, which will change our viewer to that exact layout so we can directly see how the skin as we designed it would translate onto mobile. Now that can look better or worse. In this specific case, it looks more or less okay. Maybe these buttons down here could be a little bit hard to push, so it might be a good idea to make these bigger for the mobile skin. But especially when we go and have a look at these kinds of menus or windows, we see the issue with the one-fits-all design. Up here we can switch between vertical and horizontal or landscape mobile orientation. So all in all, we have much better control over what our skins and changes would look like on every output before having to publish or preview even. This obviously makes the whole process much easier and faster because we can immediately check what changes would look like on every device as we go along. So once we checked what our skin would look like on each device and if we consider it necessary to improve what it would look like on mobile, we can go here and add the mobile version. Just click on here. And this window asks us which elements of the general skin we want to import or copy into our mobile skin version. So we can decide to leave out some elements in the mobile version because it's a smaller screen. In that case, we would simply uncheck those items. But in our example, I want to feature every skin item also in the mobile version. So I leave everything checked and click done. Now it copied all of the elements that I had put into my general skin, also into my newly created mobile skin. Here we are now working directly in the mobile skin version, okay? So that's now separate from the general skin version. Once we created this mobile skin and copied all of the elements in here, and if we now go in and change a text or whatever in this mobile version, that won't affect the text in the general version. So they're completely independent from now on. So just be mindful where it is you're currently making changes, in the general or in the mobile version. And then you obviously also have the option to delete the newly created mobile skin and go back to how we are used to having just one general skin for everything. Once we created a mobile skin version and have our mobile tab here on the right and all of our visualization options up here, we can now simply go in and edit the elements we think are not perfect yet. So I would just click in here in this window and start moving elements around, change text sizes, and scroll until this layout looks perfect on a mobile screen. That's how I would like my info window to look on mobile, optimized for a smaller vertical screen. And if we go back to the general skin, we can see that there's quite a difference between the two. Now, we did design a perfect window for when the mobile is held in vertical, which is how most tours start, but it's true that when the user decides to turn his mobile and watch the tour in horizontal or in landscape, we may encounter yet some of its own problems. You can see and scroll to read everything, but it's not ideal by any means. To avoid this, there's a setting which is the following. Up here in this drop-down, you'd select that when viewed in landscape on a mobile, the tour shows the general skin, which is more similar in terms of layout and orientation than the vertical mobile skin we have just designed. So when we turn our mobiles to landscape, rather than seeing this skin version, we would actually see this one. So in our case, with this window composition, that would actually work much better. Working with these two tabs is very versatile and handy because we can always move or copy elements from one tab to the other. For example, with both skin versions already existing, let's create a new element in the general skin so you can see this function of moving an element to the other skin too. So, this element. The first way to move this to our mobile skin is to click on the element in the list and drag it without letting go onto the mobile skin tab. As you can see, we now have a little plus icon. If we would let go now, it would copy this element to the mobile skin, maintaining it also in the general skin. If, however, before letting go, we push the Shift key on our keyboard, it would actually move this element from the general to the mobile skin, eliminating it from the general skin. In this case, let's create a copy. Now we have it in the general skin, and when we open the mobile skin, we also have it in here. The other way of doing that is selecting the element and up here in the menu under Edit, copy, and then go to the other tab and in here, click Paste. Here it is. Of course, you can also copy and paste with your keyboard Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. Finally, let's talk about the actions that the elements have assigned. So at the time of creating your mobile skin, where your general skin elements get duplicated and form the new mobile skin, if an element in your general skin had the action of opening another general skin element, so this house info, for example, which shows this panel, if this action existed when creating your mobile skin tab, then the program maintains this action also for the mobile skin. But not only that, it also understands it should open the mobile counterpart of what it opens in the general skin. So if we have a look at the action, it shows me that it'll open info photo, which is the one we have created inside the mobile skin, not the general skin. In fact, if we create new show hide actions inside the mobile tab, it'll only offer me to show hide elements that actually exist inside the mobile tab. It won't offer the elements that are in the general tab, just to not mix things up. As you can see, the program respected the actions but applied to the mobile skin elements in all of these buttons here. So the program does translate the actions to the mobile format elements, and you don't have to manually tell it to open that panel, but taken from the mobile skin rather than from the general one. So if you have old tours with old skins and you now want to go in and optimize its mobile visualization, you don't have to go and manually change all actions or relink them to refer to those newly created mobile skin elements. The program will do that automatically for you. That is different, however, to when you now go and add or edit something in the general skin when the mobile skin does already exist. So when I go and tell this button in the general skin to also open this element, that we did in the general skin. But in the mobile skin, that won't be considered as we already have two independent skins, which we now work separately on. So this type of retroactive action you would actually have to do twice, once in each skin. From this dynamic, I'm sure that you'll be able to see that the best way of working would be to first create your general skin from A to Z and completely finish it with all its elements, their actions and links, etc., before then clicking on the mobile tab to create your mobile skin version, so you do actually copy all elements and actions from the general skin over to the new mobile skin, and then start adapting that mobile version to make it work and look perfect on all mobile devices. And that's how the dual skin editor works. We hope you like this new way of getting even better skins with a couple of touch-ups. We're sure that these few clicks will take your virtual tour experiences to a new level where automated responsiveness can't compete. Thanks for watching.